So my dad learned a valuable skill from my grandfather, which was how to make corn liquor. And good thing about living on the mountain and having the hills and everything, there was lots of places to hide your still. And so my dad had a still out in the woods and had been making corn liquor. And my mother had a paper route. And so my dad tells my mother, "Oh, Terry, you're looking so tired and wore out. Let me take you a route this week." And so my mom thought, "Oh my gosh, how kind that was of him to do that for her." But really, he wanted to not be stopped by the police when he made his deliveries. So he would run and do mom's paper route and at the same time hit everybody in between and deliver the moonshine. And he had promised my mom that he would not moonshine anymore. And so dad comes home and he crawls in the bed to take a little nap. And mom decides that she's going to go to the grocery store in town. So she gets up, gets dressed, gets us dressed, and goes to town and goes to the grocery store. And the little guy that worked at the grocery store took the groceries out, and she said, "Just put them in the trunk." And she popped the trunk on her Dodge Dart. And when she did, he promptly closed the trunk. All the color washed out of his face. He comes over to the side in the window and he said, "Miss Loggins, the trunk's full." And she goes, "Trunk is full?" And so she thought that was really strange. And she goes, "Okay, hold on a second." And so she gets out, opens the trunk, sees all this moonshine that he hasn't unloaded yet in the trunk, looks around, closes the trunk, and she comes home. And she tells my dad, in a very loud, shrill voice, that she'll kill him. That he's to go down and pour out all that moonshine, and she gives him a baseball bat, and she says, "You go take care of that still." And not thinking about how she phrased her words, said, "Don't come home until all the liquor is gone." And so my dad took his baseball bat and his jacket, and he went off into the woods. And sundown comes, and dad's not back. Next morning, he's not back. Well, about 2 o'clock the next afternoon, here comes my dad, staggered up through the cornfield, and comes and sits on the back steps. And mom says, "Jerry, where the hell have you been? I've been so worried." And he said, "I wasn't coming home until the liquor was all gone." And she says, "Oh my God, you stink. You're just, this is terrible." And then he starts to throw up. So she just left him outside all day long. And she kept going out there and rolling him over so he didn't aspirate on his own vomit. And then about 5 o'clock, she called my Uncle Ray and asked Ray to help get my dad in the house and get him cleaned up. So my Uncle Ray goes and gets the water hose and hoses him down, strips him down naked, puts clean underpants on him, tosses him over his shoulder, and then puts him to bed. That was his idea of getting him cleaned up. And so my dad goes to bed, and the next day was laundry day. And so all the sheets in the house were stripped, and we had washed them all. We had gone down to the creek, and there was a big washing stone in the middle of the creek, and we'd wash on that rock and rinse it out and bring it all home and wring it out and hang it up. And so all the clean sheets are all over the line. And mom hears something and she says, "What is that god awful noise?" And I went outside and I come back in and I said, "Mom, it's your billy goat." And she goes, "What's the matter with him?" I said, "I don't know, but he doesn't look good." And so mom goes outside and she goes, "Oh my God, it's Billy." And she goes up to him. And he's as big as round as a whiskey barrel. And she hollers for my dad. And the goat, instead of going like, "Bah," he goes, "Bleh." And when he makes a noise, it sounds like something's gurgling, like he's really full of water. So My dad comes out and he sees the goat and he goes, "Oh my God." And about that time the goat goes down, he goes, "Bleh." And he lay on his side out in the yard for about 10 minutes and he finally died. And my mom, she loved that goat and she had bottle fed him and she just cried and cried and cried. And she told my dad he was just scum of the earth and to leave and never come back. And you know, he killed an innocent animal. Because what had happened is the goat had followed my dad. And when he knocked over the still, finally, it ate all the corn mash. And when he ate the corn mash and the booze, it swole up. So the goat lays out there for several hours. And mom said, "And you're going to bury him." And so she gets him a shovel. And she said, "And I don't mean a foot deep. You bury him deep enough, no dog can dig him up." And so dad is trying to pull this goat and he's hung over and doesn't feel good, and so he can't pull him, so he calls for my brothers and they wrap a rope around his antlers and they're pulling the goat. Well, mom had had some azalea bushes that had died and dad had chopped them down, and sticking up out of the ground was the stump of the azalea bushes, and it caught Billy on the side and he exploded. And so corn mash goes everywhere, all over mom's clean sheets, in mom's hair, all over mom's clothes, and my dad is just standing there like this, dumbfounded. And mom didn't say a word. She kept very, very calm, and she walked in the house, and she got her purse and her keys, and she left, and she went to go stay at my Aunt Tracy's house in Ashboro for 3 days and didn't come home. And so that night I heard my dad on the phone, and he goes, "Tracy, tell her, okay, tell her." And he goes, "Tell her I buried him so deep no dog can dig him up. Yes, and I made him a wee marker. Yes, tell her. And tell her I put flowers on the grave. Yes, yes. And also tell her I rewashed all the sheets and I made the beds. But she's got to come home."